Hi TP-Link engineers, I wanted to make a video just demonstrating what I'm talking about in my email as well. Now, I'm recording right now on my Quest. I'm not connected to any other computer or anything, it's not connected. I'm only connected to the Wi-Fi, which is then connected over the 6 gigahertz signal. And 3GS on meters and Wi-Fi 6, and you can see the transmit speed here is at 1441, and it should be a lot higher than this. When I tested this just a second ago, it was up to 19, so that was a lot better. But you can see it's fluctuating. Now it's up to 1921. And as long as it stays over 14, it really is not that big of an issue. But if you start using this for an extensive time, and then maybe about 10 to 30 minutes, it will actually dip down to almost unusable 320 megabits per second. And this is not stable at all. Now, compared to my Quest 2, let me just show you here. This is where my router is currently situated, a couple of meters from my PC. My PC is connected to that via the cable, and then I'm connecting wirelessly to that. Now, when I'm using my Quest 2, I connect to this access point here, which makes it dedicated to this. And when I do that, I get a really stable signal at 1200 megabits per second. Okay, it occurred to me that I probably should show you what happens when you're using a 5 gigahertz net on the Quest 3. So if we go down here and take a look, you can see that our speed is at 1280 megabits per second. And here too, it's fluctuating. Now it's down to 960. And this, I just want to back up to 1080. This is dedicated. That means there's nothing else connected to this Wi-Fi signal. Now it's up to 1200, where it's supposed to be. It's supposed to stay there stable, but it dips down again. So as you can tell, it's not working as it's intended at all. Just to show you guys, I'm actually going to go back on our Quest 2. So let's take a look at our Wi-Fi here. We're also connected to the 5 gigahertz, but if we look at the signal here, you'll see it's 100% stable. It's not moving from this speed at all. And using that access point with this headset is brilliant, with no interruptions at all. So there you have it. Okay, back to 6 gigahertz. So now you can see it's still fluctuating. And I haven't yet connected to any virtual desktop or AirLink or anything. This is just the communication between the headset and that router. And you can see that the transmit speed is still very unstable and fluctuating. So the problem does not lie here. The problem lies between the headset and the router. They're not communicating correctly. And to be quite frank, it's probably not even TP-Link's fault. I believe that this is an issue with the headset, but you might be able to identify the problem and maybe convene that problem or communicate that problem to Meta. I hope you, at least you do. So now you can see it's 1441. So this was just to demonstrate the problem, that it's not related to anything else than the actual communication between the headset and the router. This should be stable at 24 gigahertz per second, or 2400 megabits per second. Right now it's, well, now we're up over 21. So as you can tell, it's not stable at all. It's fluctuating all over the place. So I thank you for looking into this. I hope that I really hope that Meta will actually send you a headset instead of you have to wait for a month to get one. But that's fine. At least you're working on it. And I love TP-Link routers, so I really hope that we can fix this and figure out what's wrong. I'll thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you later.